How do you catch a great white shark?
American non-profit Ocearch have been tagging and tracking great whites around the world since 2007.
How many sharks have you caught?
Over 200 white sharks.
All using this method?
Yeah.
Collaborating with local scientists and funded by sponsorship and donations, they have shaken up ocean research with their controversial methods.
You know, we're here to solve the puzzle of the Mediterranean white shark.
Now they're coming to Europe, aiming to show how the survival of these top predators can restore abundance to our threatened seas.
8 weeks and one chance at one shark. Losing is not really an option.
This is the first day fishing in French waters. Ocearch have been in Spanish waters up to this point. They've caught a couple of blue sharks, but no great whites yet. My understanding is that they've got a better chance of catching great whites here, but I'm still not sure that today is going to be my day.
Oh, thanks.
Hello.
How are you, sir?
I'm all right. It's great to be here.
Chris Fisher is the founder of Ocearch and leader of Expedition Save the Med.
Yeah, this is my boat. I basically bought it and I just donated to Ocearch.
We meet not in the Med itself, but 500 miles away off the coast of Brittany. Waters that Ocearch believe serve as summer feeding grounds for great whites.
Our strategy was, we're gonna pick up the bluefin tuna off of northwest Spain, which is where we spent the last 2 weeks. Thought maybe we'll get lucky and one will swing by. That didn't happen, right? But now the first place they're gonna bump into seals is Brittany, France.
There are plenty of people, sort of scientists and the like, who really aren't sure about...
Most people say they're not there.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what we're hearing, but they don't know what we know. They don't have the experience we have. When you're talking about the UK and Ireland, the scientists will say they're not there. You talk to the commercial fishermen, they'll tell you they're there. We know we not only need to solve the puzzle of the white sharks' lives and help people understand how important they are the lion of the ocean, the wolf, the balance keeper. If we don't see a lot of sharks, the recovering seal population is going to decimate your fish stocks. So you will lose all your mackerel here. You will lose your sea bass here. You will lose a lot of your crustaceans here. The seals will just wipe it out. The key is try to get some tags on some of these before it's too late.
Converted from a former crabbing boat, the vessel is a unique resource, equipped with a makeshift lab where local researchers are invited to collaborate with Ocearch's resident vet.
These transmit in real time the position of the animals.
And obviously you're collecting a huge amount of data here that then you're basically sharing with whoever wants it?
It's meant to be open source because it's such a huge resource. The biggest battle that sharks face is data deficit. We don't know how many animals there are. We don't know what areas are important to them, what foods are important to them, what threats they face. This type of research answers those questions.
You just gotta catch one first.
We just have to catch one first.
Brett, how do you catch a great white shark?
We don't use conventional methods like big fishing rods and monofilament line or anything like that. We go through a lot of effort to not harm the shark and to not fight it very long. I use a set of buoys and rope and cable and a specially made super strong hook to get the job done.
How many sharks have you caught?
Over 200 white sharks.
All using this method?
Yeah.
Do you still feel the same way now as you did 200 sharks ago?
I think I do. There's so much weight on my shoulders. All our permits and everything rely on sharks being healthy and swimming off healthy. If we have a shark die on deck, the world will know.
Ocearch maintain that, for the shark at least, stress levels remain low throughout the 15 minutes they are out of the water, while the team collects an unparalleled array of data. But there has been plenty of criticism around the level of intrusion taking a boneless fish out of the sea might cause.
Do you have any concerns about the methods that Ocearch employ?
Of course, I have some concerns. They're not made to be pulled out of water and have a hole in the mouth to keep breathing. But as far as I know, there's never been any recent cases of really bad thing happening to sharks after capture. We should consider the amount of information that has been brought by Ocearch. It's impressive. There has to be some consequences. But I think those consequences should be considered in relationship to what they bring to the knowledge and to the conservation of those same white sharks.
Would you be surprised if we caught a great white?
I would be surprised, but I would be thrilled.
Gotta get back in this.
Hopefully, you know, this kind of wind against current will shift around here. But yeah, it's gotten kind of nasty here.
A lot of people in the scientific community aren't huge fans of the idea of bringing a boneless animal out of the water, right?
Oh,
but you know
years.
That these criticisms exist, right?
Yeah, but I think most of them are just based in professional jealousy and lack of access to the tool. It's not about the shark. 92 peer-reviewed papers later, we got the most pedigree in the space. We are the best in the world at what we do, by far. And if anybody wants to, you know, come on over and measure up because they got a problem, you're welcome to step on board anytime. Meanwhile, our oceans are tanking and they got no plan. I got no time for those fools. We get one though. We're gonna get one. I think we could get one tomorrow out here.
Ocearch seem pretty confident that they're gonna catch a great white somewhere on this trip. But I'm interested to know from local people here in Brittany whether they think that seems likely. Have you heard rumours of great white sharks in these waters?
Non, j'ai pas vraiment entendu.
Nothing?
Non, rien.
Requin blanc ici, on n'en a jamais vu. Enfin, j'ai pas entendu parler.
Petit requin, on en entend parler. Requin blanc, c'est pas quelque chose de courant ici. Après.
Ça ne nous fait pas peur, nous, pour le moment. Ouais, voilà.
Pourquoi pas, peut-être un jour, si les conditions se réunissent. Donc.
What does he think?
It's a Polak. Bah, poète-poète, il va se barrer parce qu'il va se faire croquer.
J'ai vu un requin à Sainte-Anne-du-Pourzig. J'ai peut-être dans les 6-7 mètres. Il avait échoué. 35 ans, 40 ans.
It wouldn't surprise you then to know that there were great whites in these waters.
Bah, pourquoi pas? On n'a pas s'étonné. Des requins, ça existe. On a vu des requins ici, pas loin. Pourquoi pas là, ici à Brest?
Merci beaucoup.
Kenavo. Kenavo, comme on dit en breton.
I don't know what you're saying, but that sounds great.
Confirmed sightings of great whites in Europe are few and far between. But decades of overfishing, pollution and poaching have led to rarer sightings, and the species is now critically endangered. At the University of Western Brittany, scientists working with Ocearch tend to focus on more common visitors to these waters, including a close relative of the great white, the poor beagle.
That's a poor beagle.
Yeah, see how similar they look.
Do you think a lot of the sightings of great whites are probably those?
Or opposite.
Or vice versa.
Maybe. Yeah, maybe. You can see? This is a shark, you see. You yeah. should be very afraid.
I am. I mean, I think it's dead, but apart from that, I'm terrified. Whoa, okay. That's your harpoon, right?
Yes, that's what I use for taking biopsy of the poor beagles. Basically, that's the main difference with what Ocearch is doing is that we are not tagging them.
Yeah.
And we're using non-invasive methodology. So just by diving, waiting, having like a little basket of sardine and waiting there. And then when you're in a good position, you just tag on the back.
Is it a source of frustration that people like me and the general public are really only interested in the great white?
I would say sometimes for funding, some people are more keen into giving money for something a bit more sensational.
Yeah, there's a big difference between getting a great white out of the water on a platform and showing me your freezer of little sharks.
Back on board, the crew are busy setting lines and baits around their fishing spot. Though the expedition is focused on the great white, Ocearch are keen to aid local scientists with their own research into other species.
Are you hoping to catch poor beagles?
Yeah, specifically targeting poor beagles on the rod and reel.
Good luck.
See you later.
See you later. And off they go. The lines are baited and in the water. Now begins the long and perhaps slightly boring process of waiting and hoping for a bite. How hard is it to keep track of all the lines you've got out?
I mean, there's a lot of people watching them.
Yeah, sure.
Because it's, you know, any moment something could change.
I'm getting impatient.
And it's the thing, we're waiting months in the making, so we're happy to stay here and just to look at this buoy for hours. And the minute and the second you will have the movement, you'll be happy to see it. What can you see?
porbeagle. Can you see it?
I can clearly see a fin. I think I saw the tail as well. Right.
At least we have sharks.
Busy morning.
Got a couple
baits in. Okay, around.
We take a poor beagle. We're not fussy.
We're trying.
Yeah, there is one you just dove, but there was one poor beagle here.
A near miss, perhaps, but with the day coming to an end, our hopes of witnessing a shark close up begin to drift away.
Hey, Ocearch supporters and great white shark fans.
Please click donate today and help us be proud of what we deliver to our grandchildren.
It's been an interesting day, but we've not caught anything. Presumably you're not worried.
As you know, it's very dynamic current here, big tides, but we're seeing the life we need to see, right? So we don't feel too far off. The mental battle is tougher than the battle that may ensue once you bump into the right, you know, type of shark.
As the trip goes on, the pressure does increase, right?
The pressure will build if we're talking in 5 weeks from now and we still haven't seen an animal. But there's only so much we can do. If that's something we learn is not seeing one white shark in 8 weeks moving through the region doing this, that's an alarming situation.
Is there a sense that there was a lot of hubris around coming here? And if you don't back that up, does that reflect badly on you? How do you feel?
Oh, I don't care about me.
But this is personal for you, right?
Yeah. You know, you're trying to, you want to keep everybody motivated, right? So sometimes you know, you don't want that to really come out on deck around the team. For us, losing is not an option. I mean, losing is not delivering to our children. I want to be proud of how I leave it a little better than I find it. I hope everyone else does too. That's really, in the end, all I think we're chasing.
Ocearch spent 6 weeks in European waters without catching or even seeing a great white shark. On departure, they called for greater regulation and enforcement of marine protected areas to crack down on the destructive effects of overfishing and help restore abundance to our seas.